Well, you're going to love our next interview. Of all the people that we managed to track down in the Hajj is a Hollywood movie actor, Omar Reagan, now a Muslim. Thanks so much for joining us. You've acted in the movie Rush Hour 2 as a double for Chris Tucker. Tell me about how you went from Hollywood to Hajj. That's an amazing journey in itself.
Yeah, when you put it like that, it kind of, I don't know. It's the first thing that comes to my mind, like, wow, how did I get here? I can say I'm grateful. I know my mother, she converted to Islam when I was young. But I grew up making a lot of mistakes,
We won't get into that.
Please don't tell nobody. But then I started working and I was always raised to be a good person. And then I joined up with this group called the Canadian Dawah Association, which I end up being the program developer for it. And we started doing little functions like Stop the Violence and things in Canada and things in the U.S. And then they said, hey, we're sending you to Hajj. And I was like, what? And I didn't feel like I was ready, so I started trying to study, and I came last year.
All right, now, as I mentioned, you've doubled for Chris Tucker. You know what I'm going to ask you? I got to ask you, what would Chris Tucker say if he was on Hajj?
He'd probably say something like, hey man, it's a lot of people and they pushing me. No, you can't say. It's all for Allah, man. All for Allah. It's only one God. Numerous things. And you know this, man. Maybe this. I got new life.
How do Hollywood, you're still working in Hollywood, so.
Oh, yeah.
It's quite an interesting balancing act. Do Hollywood and Hajj really go together? You maintain those two roles?
Hollywood and Hajj. Yeah, that's controversy right there. That is controversy. It's like, huh? When you hear it.
But, is that Bernie Mac now?
Hollywood Hodge. Now, you know, it's conflicting, but it works because Hollywood teaches you kind of like put on this, be a fake person, be another person. And Hodge teaches you to really be yourself. It strips you of everything that you thought was so important and everything that you really fight for. It's about me and what I need. And Hajj, man, you know, you sleep on the ground, you know, you wear nothing, as you can see.
And we don't want to really show you wearing nothing. He is dressed, by the way.
That is true. That is true. But you stripped of all those worldly possessions, you know, and you kind of, everybody's on the same level. No matter how much money you have, we're the same. So I can take that back to the U.S. with me, you know. Be a nice person, be a good person. What Islam really teaches is have good character, good manners.
Tell me, Omar, does it hurt your Hollywood profile, your Hollywood career, that you have such a high profile as a Muslim? As you mentioned, you're in Hajj, you're talking to us on TV, you're part of the Canadian Dawah Association.
I don't know. That's a good question. I'm going to find out when I go back home.
If you need a job, I'll talk to my boss.
Yeah, do that, because you asked, they'll be like, you was on Al Jazeera? What? I'm like, they love us.
It's been good talking to you, Omar Reagan.
It's been good talking to you too.
I'm going to let you get back to the other Rush Hour. This is more like Rush Hour 10. It took us about 3 hours and 15 minutes to get you out here. I don't even think about how long it's going to take to get you back.
Yeah, what is the opposite of Rush Hour? Slow motion over here. Boy. You can't go nowhere. It's just too many people. They in mountains and everything. It's beautiful though. It is beautiful.
Omar Reagan, you have yourself a beautiful Hajj and a safe trip home.
Thank you.
We'll be continuing the coverage from the heart of the Hajj in the days to come, but for now I'm going to hand you back to Imran in the studio.